Yup, so this will be the first. I'm doing it before free agency starts. Yes, we have the 2023 NFL Draft interior defensive lineman prospect rankings. Obviously, I'm doing the top nine. There's other guys I'm going to say that could be in this, but I'm not going to put in because, well, they really just don't seem to fit the mold or whatever. There's other guys that are good. Trust me. Not all these guys are going to be great. There's guys that I'm not going to rank in this video that could be good. So, yeah, keep an eye out for those guys. But, yep, I'm going to introduce you guys to the nine best interior defensive lineman prospects. I'm going to go into them, and then I'm going to rank them after. Here we go, guys. 2023 NFL Draft interior defensive lineman prospect rankings. I hope you guys enjoy. Yeah, let's go.
DJ, he'll fake it, pump fake, wants to go down the field, and he's hit. Pickens takes him to the turf on a sack. The first of the day on DJ.
Well, there's a new left guard in there. That's Mitchell Mays, and that's who got beat on the pressure. It was quick pressure, but it was also excellent coverage downfield by...
Okay, guys, so when you look at Zach Pickens, first thing I gotta say is... my bad. He is a... pretty quick guy inside, actually, for the size he is. Of course, 300 pounds, 6'4". Obviously, his arm is 34.38, which is decently long. His hands, not super big. 40 was 4.89, but he's actually pretty speedy for a bigger guy, which he is, obviously, like I just said. But as well, he's a run defender. Like, that's what he does. He stops for a run. I'll just put it that way. But we look at Pickens. Yeah, he had 42 tackles, 2.5 sacks, 3 passes batted down in 2022. Yeah, solid run defender, which he is. But not a factor passer. I'll tell you this, he's got some speed, so maybe he will be in the future. That's all I gotta say. And obviously, we look a little farther back. He was decent in 2021, I'll put it that way. Obviously, breakout as a junior, blah, 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 blah. But yeah, good size and quickness with athleticism, like I said. And he's riser, interior passer ability. Yeah, I do think he could do this. Obviously, he's not a factor right now, but if a team can develop him into that, he could be a really good guy. Obviously, he is a run defender. And we, of course, look at his stats. Of course, going to 2022, he had 42 total tackles, 4 tackles for loss, because again, he isn't very consistent with that, but he can do it. And yeah, of course, he had 2.5 sacks, 3 passes defended, and he did have a nice bum recovery, but he is for sure a run defender. Now let's get right to his grades. And okay, for Zach Pickens, we look at his, in terms of all the categories, I'll just get through this now. Strength is the first one, how strong you are. Beefiness, well, I'll talk about that in a second. Explosion. Handwork quickness, handwork fluidness, handwork efficiency-ness, that's not even a word, whatever. Handwork effectiveness, my bad. Run defense resistance, speed, technique, versatility, relentlessness, bull rush, finesse or speed rush, improvisation tackling, block shedding, move toolbox, what is it called? Overall, and then comparison, which for Zach Pickens will be Jonathan Hankins. If you didn't know, as I went through Zach Pickens, he is out of South Carolina, which is important to know because obviously they have one of the better defenses in the country, in my opinion. Not one of the best, but one of the better ones. Okay, but for Zach Pickens, we look at his strength. I'll give him almost him at 4 because for a big guy, he is pretty strong. He can move guys. He can definitely do that. For a big guy, pretty darn strong. Definitely can hold his own. He knows what he's doing. Okay, for his beefiness, okay, he's a beefy dude. I'll put it that way. Not super duper beefy, but he's beefy. I'll put it like that. I'll actually give him a 4 for this. I'm not going to give him anything higher because, again, he's not like huge, huge. He's a big dude, but not huge, huge. I'll definitely give him a 4, though. He's a pretty big guy. For his explosion, he's a pretty quick guy. I'll put him that way. But it's not anything super special, so I'll put him a little bit higher, 3.3. Handwork fluidness. Okay, I mean, my bad, quickness. His hands are not quick at all. They're kind of brick hands, in my opinion. 2.5, I'll give him. Honestly, they could be worse, but yeah, they're kind of bricks. His fluidness, though, again, it's not quick, but I do think that he moves them pretty, like, again, they're kind of brick hands, but it's not super clunky, so I'll give him 2.7 for this. Again, he's not really there. Effectiveness, I'll give him this. When he does make a move with, obviously trying to get off blocks, he's actually pretty good with this. He gets his hands on them. He's productive with his hands. I'll give him 3.1. Run defending resistance. Does he hold his own up front? He definitely does. I'll give him a 3.6, dude. This dude is the guy you want as your nose tackle for sure against the run. He can definitely stop it. That's, of course, pretty big. Maybe not as important as it used to be in the NFL, but it's still important. So, yeah, 3.6. For speed, I mean, he's a pretty honestly quick dude for a big guy. I can't give him anything special, but yeah, he's above average, 3.4. Technique versatility, not really versatile at all. I should give him 2.4. This is not something that Zach Pickens is really going to get done much in the NFL. He relies a ton on stunts to get his sacks few and far between. He's not really your type of guy there. To 2.4. Relentlessness, he doesn't always give up, but I won't say he's like, if the play's over, the play's over. He's not just hammering away, but he's pretty good. 2.8. His bull rush is his best move. Sorry, I'm talking a little fast, but yeah. If you don't know what bull rush is, well, a bull rush is how fast you get to the quarterback. You're just like basically trying to ram a guy through. But yeah, he's pretty good with this. Definitely his best move. 2.4. His finesse rush, again, he kind of has brick hands, which if you didn't know, his hands are slow. Again, it's not super clunky. That's why I would say his fluidness is better than his quickness, but he's not a quick guy when it comes to moving his arms around, making moves. But yeah, his finesse rush, I'll give him a 2.4. I mean, it's not very good. His speed rush, I will give him this. He can get bent. He has a couple decent bend for a guy in the interior, which is kind of crazy to say. But yeah, he can make some moves there, a couple juice in there. But yeah, I have to give him 2.5. He's not great. Improvisation, he honestly does get stuck a lot, like latched on to defenders. But again, he does have some decent explosion, so it doesn't always get guy bite him. But I do have to give that a 2.8. Tackling, okay. How do I rate his tackling? This is actually pretty tough because he actually did not make a ton of tackles. He does when it comes to arm tackles, he's actually pretty good. He does keep guys in tone. He definitely contains them. The problem with him is he's not very good in open space, and he especially gets beat on the zone read. So I have to give him a 2.9 for this one. I like Zach Pickens a lot, but he's not really good here. Block shedding. The difference between block shedding and these other rushes is that it's a pass rush. Block shedding is simply can you get off a block quick. He's pretty decent with this for, again, a power rushing interior run defender. 3.2, it's not terrible, not awful, not great. Move toolbox, I'll give him this. He does have some moves that he likes to use, like experiment with. It's honestly pretty cool to see. I have to give him 3.4. I'll do the math for the overall, and yep, I'll come right to you, and yep. Yeah, and overall for his rating comes out at 3.08, which if you didn't know, it's in the average part of it, or almost to below average. I kind of expected this because, honestly, right now as a prospect, he could be an average defensive tackle. That's kind of what it comes down to. Is he that right now? Probably not, because again, he's just really a run defender. But you never know in the future. He's probably a low floor type of guy. I mean, low ceiling type of guy, but his floor isn't terrible. Again, he's got a lot in the twos. He's probably a below average guy right now. But I do like Zach Pickens. I like him a lot, honestly. He's a good player for South Carolina. I got to watch a lot of him. So yeah, Zach Pickens, a 3.08 grade. We will, of course, get to that in the end. But yeah, here we go. Yep, 3.08 for Zach Pickens. Next guy, here we go.
Flushed out to the right, and he's brought down. Keanu Benton brings down Tagovailoa. Tons of pressure to Tagovailoa. Benton brought him down.
Okay, and when we look at Keanu Benton, I'll put it first things first. He is a pretty well-rounded guy. I'll just say that. And obviously, we look at this. It's pretty short. I'm not gonna say a ton about him because again, well, we'll look at his 45 bit basically. But I will tell you this. He is a pretty well-rounded guy. There really isn't much to go off of in terms of his, like, when you watch him play, there really isn't anything you're like, Jesus. There's stuff he does well, there's stuff he doesn't do well. But, like, obviously, he's not very versatile, but he is a pretty good player, in my opinion. But, yeah, Keanu Benton, either way. 36 tackles, 4.5 sacks, pretty good there. Senior bowl, short snake, quickness, physicality, again, well-rounded. Ben did not do much in 2019-2020, total 20 tackles each season. But again, Ben has a quality skill set and upside so that he could rise to senior, blah, 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 blah. Yeah. Keanu Benton is a well-rounded player. That's really the best way I can tell you. Yeah, obviously, he was a second in the Big Ten with 2 forced fumbles. He can definitely be that opportunistic in, of course, 2020. But yeah, we look at this year, again, 4.5 sacks, 10 tackles for loss. He is very, very relevant and prevalent in the run game as well. 10 tackles for loss, again, 4.5 sacks, career high in the college. Again, none of these guys are getting 15 sacks. We'll get to another guy who might, but yeah. He is a very, very, very well-rounded player. Let's get right to his rating. Let me just change that to Keanu so we actually know who this is. Okay, so for Keanu Benton, obviously look at his strength. Again, this isn't something you're like, Jesus, he doesn't really show you a ton of this. When it comes to just straight up blowing guys away. For that reason, I have to keep it, and like, he's about average with it. It's not terrible, like, he can hold his own, so I will give it 3.1. But his beefiness, yeah, he's a big dude, so I will have to give him a 3.5 for this. I get, This is something guys can't control, but it still is important. I'm sorry. It really is. He's a beefy dude. The reason I'm not giving him higher is because, you know, I'll give him 3.8. Oh, yeah. He's a big dude. Explosion, not really that explosive. Honestly, it's one of the things he struggles with. Not really great here. He's a big dude, and he's not really super athletic either. I do think he's, but he does make it up for some of the other stuff he does. He is efficient getting off the line, but again, he's not very explosive. So let's give him a 2.4. Handwork quickness, he's actually pretty quick with his hands. He knows what he's doing with them, and he can move them around pretty quick. Again, he gets off the line quick. That gives him time to know what he wants to do with his hands. Obviously, manipulating the guards is something he's really good at, but yeah, his handwork quickness is definitely there. Fluidness, that kind of gets clumped up, because again, we'll get to his improvisation in a second. He's pretty good with this. I'll give it a 3.2. It's a lot around average, because again, he doesn't have the type of like quickness to really go around with fluidness, but he's pretty fluid. Handwork effectiveness, he puts his hands in the right spot when he gets the chances to. He's pretty good with that. Defending resistance, I mean, he's okay here. I wouldn't say it's anything special. He kind of gets moved, not a ton, but again, he's kind of beefy, so it kind of helps him there. Lack of strength doesn't help either, but yeah, I have to give his run defense. It's a little, he does get pushed a little, so 2.8. Speed, he's not fast, too. I mean, yeah, that's really nothing else to say. Technique versatility, I mean, it's pretty limited with him, I'll put it that way. He is pretty quick with his hands. I'll give him like around average with that reason though. He's a pretty much a bull rush type of guy. He gets his hands in the right spot for them to move the offensive lineman, but yeah, there's really no versatility at all with him. Relentlessness, I will give him this though. He's a pretty relentless guy. I'll tell you, like, you do not want to go line up against him. He'll move you if he wants to. And again, if he doesn't win on the first move, he will win on the second. Bull rush, his best move, again, like with a lot of these guys, 3.6. His finesse rush, there really isn't much of it. I don't even think he did much of it at all. But again, he gets his hands on the guys quick and gets in the right spot. Huge for him. Speed rush, didn't do any of that. Like, it's kind of like, I can't even grade this. There's none of it. Like, that's it. He improvises pretty well as well. Again, yeah, it comes with the relentlessness, but he does try to find ways to get the quarterback in different ways, which is good to see. So, 3.4. Tackling, I mean, again, not much of this. You don't see a lot of it. But when you do see it, he does make tackles. I don't think he missed many. I'll give him 3.5. Block shedding, again, not terrible, not great. 3, average, whatever. Move toolbox, he really doesn't, again, not much versatility. What I mean by technique versatility is how he gets off the line, what he does with it, how good he is with that. Again, without that versatility, it's really hard for him to get a ton of different moves. But he's got an okay box. I'll give him, I don't know, 1.5. And his overall, let's get right to it. Okay, so for Keanu Benton, it comes out to a 2.84 grade overall for him. Obviously, it's lower than Zach Pickens, but I don't think it's terrible. Again, he's a pretty well-rounded guy, but again, that technique versatility is his real weakness. He can't use different ways to get off the line because of his size and the fact that he doesn't have a ton of speed. If he had better speed, he could get off the line faster. He could use different ways to approach the guards and centers. If he was able to use that better, and especially taking on double teams, if he was able to split them, that would be huge. But obviously he can't, because again, he's a big dude. There's really nothing else to say for him. And obviously, he's not really elite in anything either, really good or elite. He's got some stuff he's pretty solid at. Again, his size does help. That's probably the best attribute. But he's not a terrible player at all. I just gotta say this. He's not particularly good at anything. Because of his size, his technique versatility suffers because of it. And if you want me to know, technique versatility, it's how many different ways you can approach the guard and the tackle before you get latched onto him. That's how I basically describe it. But yeah, it is an important part of it. But yeah, 2.84 grade for him. Obviously, Grover Stewart is a comparison. Because again, Grover Stewart isn't great at anything, but he's not bad at anything. Helps him out a lot. And of course, when you can do that in the NFL, you can be a pretty darn good player. But 2.84 overall grade for him.
Indeed. And now they've got his jersey and he throws it in the dirt. So they finally got a little bit of pressure on him. Quicker than the officials did.
Exactly.
Yeah, that's.
Okay, for Gervon Dexter, first things first, he did have 50 tackles and 2 sacks, 1 pass defended, and an interception during 2022. He put together an impressive game against Utah and LSU. Those were probably his best games. I would say against Bama, though, he was pretty decent. Whatever. Dexter also played really well against Kentucky, collecting 7 tackles, 0.5 sacks, and a diving interception. He is a beast as a run defender and showed more pass rush ability in 2022. However, he is not much of a pass rusher for the NFL and will probably get pulled into a sub-package, probably, yeah. He's not a very big dude. Yeah, his 40 was not good either. Even though that Florida defense struggled in 2021. Dexter Flash, blah, 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 blah. Yeah. Honestly, I do think his athleticism is a little underrated. I don't think his 40 projects his athleticism. Obviously, athleticism isn't really something I need to really get into because for football players, it's not huge. Obviously, it's pretty important. But yeah, for Gilbert Dexter, he's more of an edge rusher. I'll just put it that way. He's a big dude, but he doesn't play like that. Let's get right to Gervon's grading now. And for Gervon, I'll put it this way. His strength is something that he does lack at points in games. So for that reason, I'd give him a 2.7. Sometimes though, it looks pretty decent. I'll give him that. But again, he can't hold his own on the inside really well. He's a pretty big dude though. I will give him his credit there. So for that reason, his beefiness will go up a little more than I think it could. Because again, he doesn't play like he's that big, but he's a pretty beefy dude. I'll give him 3.5. 3.5, yeah. It's a little bit above average. For his explosion, he's actually a pretty explosive dude. He's not that fast though, which is kind of an issue. But I will give it a 3.3. He looks good at getting off the line. Hard handwork quickness. He actually has pretty quick hands. One of his better attributes for sure. He moves his hands really well. When it comes to fluidness, that's an issue. Like, it's clunky. Like, if his hand gets caught on one side of the offensive lineman, he can't really shed to get to the other side. Whatever. His quickness is not as good. I'll give it a 3.1. It's not that it's not quick. His fluidness, it's not that it's not sometimes fluid, it's just inconsistent. Effectiveness, that's something he struggles with. I'll give 2.1. In terms of pass rush, he just does not put his hands in the best positions at times. And it really, really plagues him when it comes in for the rest of the down. He really struggles with that. He usually has to come back with another punch or something. He's not very good there. 2.1. Run defending resistance. He's huge there. You're not going to blow him over. You're just not going to. He drives too hard into the ground. I know that sounded really weird. But yeah, drives really hard into the ground. He makes you push him over, commit a foul. Yes, really good with that. His speed, underrated a little bit, but again, 3.2. It's not great in terms of the skill, but I don't think it's bad. Technique versatility, okay. He's not a 3-tech defender, really. He's not a 1-tech defender. He's more of like a 2-tech or a 1-high-tech. Type of guy. He can't actually play the 5 if you need him to, but for sure, his technique versatility is actually pretty good. I'll give it a 3.4. Okay, relentlessness. He's really not that much of a relentless type of pass rusher, I'll just say that. That really plagues him. Run defense, though, if he gets beat, he gets beat. There's really nothing else to say. Bull rush, not really there at all. Like, don't get to see much of it, and even then, it's not great. Finesse rush, definitely his best rush. I'll give it a 3.2. Inconsistent, but when it's on, it's on. Speed rush now. Again, since he's really not that fast, he just really can't use it a ton. And when he tries to, it's not great. 2.4. Improvisation. Again, he has one type of punch, so he really can't use it again. But he does make some. When something doesn't work, he does try to fix it. 2.6. Tackling. Not great. 2.4. He does make tackles, that's for sure. He gets in a lot. Again, a lot of sub packages. But when it comes to just straight up making arm tackles, not his best thing. Block shedding. Not great either. 2.5. Again, he's not great with a lot of stuff. That's another thing. Below average when it comes to block shedding. His move toolbox, though, I do like it again. He's got a little more versatility than these other guys because he does play those sub-packages. And again, he can play a lot of different techniques, so he does get the ability to use different type of rushes. And I do think he displayed it well. 3.5 for him. Now here's his overall grade. Here we go. And Gervon's overall grade will be a 2.91, which is a below average. I do think this fits him, though, because again, unlike, Keanu Benton, he's not your type of guy there, and obviously Zach Pickens is a more versatile player than he is. I will do say, though, that he is a versatile guy. He's just really not exceptional or really, like, he has no bread and butter, which is something you gotta realize going to the NFL, but you can plug and play him in a lot of places, which is good to see. But Gervon Dexter needs to improve on a lot if he wants to be a viable NFL player, but he is not a bad guy to take a chance on. Really not a ton of high potential either, but I do think he's a guy who could be solid in his career. Dalvin Tomlinson, obviously, is a comparison. I really do like that. Maybe not as versatile as Dalvin Tomlinson, of course, with that 3-tech ability. That he really doesn't display, because again, his relentlessness isn't really there. But yeah, Dalvin Tomlinson is his comparison. Yep, that's it for Gervon Dexter. We'll get to him in the end. Time for the big, big dude, Siaka Ika.
He's a big man right there in the middle of your screen, 72. First, he's dominating the center. Somebody else has to make a play outside of Hawkins.
I mean, if Siaki Ika is your favorite player in the draft, I don't really know what to say. Like, He is Vita Vea on steroids. I mean, there's really only one problem with him. He has brick hands. Like, if he gets stopped, he's not doing anything. But he's huge. 6'4", 358. I mean, Jesus. He's a big, big boy. Bro, he's so good. I love him. If you can get this guy to not have brick hands, he could be so good. I love this dude. Siaki Ika is so good. So, so good. Obviously, didn't have a sack. That's not very good. My bad. 2022. Of course, not with LSU. If you know, he started there. He didn't have any sacks, but he had two tackles for the last two tackles past the defense. Back-to-back plays. Siaka Iki is so good. Oh, my God. He's my favorite prospect. I'm not even kidding. He's so good. Obviously, he's going to be your nose tackle. There's room enough to stay there, but oh, so good. Here's his gradings. Okay, for Siaka Ika. Okay, his strength, I mean, he's a huge dude, so it's going to be like 4.4. I'll give you this, though. He is not the strongest player in the draft. We'll get to him when we do our offensive line rankings. But he is a strong dude. Beefiness, 5. He's special. He's special beefiness. He's so big. Explosion, I mean, he's not really explosive. Like, 2.4. Like, no. He's not moving. His handwork quickness, it's like a 1. I'll give it a 1.1. You know what that? You know, I gotta give less than 1. 0.45. Yeah. He's not quick at all. Not quick. He's a little more fluid, though. He can get his hands on guys, and he can move them a little bit. So, again, really brick hands, but he's got some fluidness. Effectiveness, 3.5. Because, again, when he gets his hands in the right spot, you're screwed. Resistance, 5. I should probably put 4.9 because we'll get to another guy who's that good. But, yeah. He might not be quite as good as the guy we're going to talk to in a little while. But, yeah. He's definitely got some resistance. I'll put it that way. Speed, 0. He's slow. He's a big dude. You know, for a big guy, I'll give him 0.2. I'll give him that. His versatility, I mean, he's a one tech type of guy. 1. He's playing one tech. There's really nothing else to say. Relentlessness, you're actually probably 0 tech. Relentlessness, he's pretty relentless. I mean, when he gets pumped, he's pumped. 4.1. Bull rush, 4.7. Speed rush, don't see it, so I kind of can't really give anything. I will say he has actually used his finesse rush a couple times. It hasn't been pretty. I'll give it 1.5. Improvisation, you don't see this either. Like, he never gets the chance to because of what he's supposed to do. He can tackle, though. I'll give him that. Like, in some of the drills I've seen him do, he can tackle. 3.2. Block shedding, he can shed blocks as well because they know he's just going to try to run him over. So that is an advantage, 3.4. His move toolbox, again, there's really not that many moves, but the ones he has do work so well. So 3.4. Time for his overall grading. Yep, here it is. Okay, I forgot to see Siaka, my bad. Okay, for Siaka, though, his overall grade came out to a 2.95, which I know it doesn't seem fair because he's going to be such a valuable nose tackle because there really aren't that many in the NFL. He will be that, though. He's literally a nose tackle. Other than that, though, he is that. He's going to be Vita Vea. Maybe not as good, but that's who he's going to be. Like, that's the type of player he's going to be because he's so big. Special type of size. Really aren't that many type of guys. But if you forget something, you got a nose tackle for the goal line. That's really about it. But, yeah, I like him a lot. Now let's get to the next guy. Here is Mozzie Smith.
Empty backfield. Here's O'Connell. Steps up in the pocket. Under pressure, and he goes down. Jalen Harrell.
Okay. Mozzie Smith is the most underrated interior defensive tackle prospect in the draft. He is so much, just so valuable at maintaining holes. Just minimizing them. He's so well at keeping his leverage to the inside so he can make plays, and he pushes the guards outside. That is what Mozzie Smith does. That is his best attribute. He is so valuable. He's not the most athletic. He's not the biggest, but he is pretty big. He's pretty tall, though, as well. Pretty big guy, obviously, but he's not the fastest. He's pretty athletic, though. He's just so, so, so good at gap control. Not, of course, he basically always gets the right leverage. Obviously, only half a sack in 2022, but he's such a quality run defender. Good pull down passing situation. Hence, Smith might be more of a rotational nose tackle. Still, he is a big body defender who is tough and physical at the point of attack with some ability to cause disruption. Obviously, he is the best A-gap defender in this draft. Maybe not most disruptive, but he's the best because he just maintains gaps just so well. It's simple as that. He was the bread and butter of that defense, the glue of it. Without him, they give up a lot more big runs. Obviously against TCU, they felt the burden when they couldn't when they basically couldn't stop the pass. Because you're not gonna run the ball against Mozzie Smith. He just even if you do, if you have a good linebacker who can tackle, Mozzie Smith will do it. He's just so important there. That's him. Obviously his stats, they ain't anything special. Like I said, only one tackle for loss, only 2.5 tackles for loss. But this dude on film is just so valuable. Like, you need these type of guys on your team. Okay, not for DJ Reader. No, that's I remember doing him, but no, not for DJ Reader. DJ Reader is his comparison because again, he's the same exact kind of the same player. His strength, he's a strong dude. He holds his point of attack really well. That's what he can do. He's really good. Again, center of gravity, he's really good at keeping. But again, 3.8, that's his strength. Beefiness, pretty beefy dude. He's definitely above average. It's not like huge. I'm not. If you're 330, you've got really good to elite size. He doesn't exactly have that, but he's a beefy dude. Explosion. He's not super explosive, but he does get off the line well enough. I'll give him a 3.2. Mozzie Smith does get off the line. Handwork quickness. I mean, he's really not doing this a lot. It's more the effectiveness and the fluidness that I like. So I will have to give this like a 2.6. Because again, he's not going to do a lot in pass rush. His fluidness. I honestly could argue this is a 4. I think I will. Because it's nice to see. Because there's really not many D-tackles. Because again, a lot of them have brick hands. He definitely doesn't. Fluidness is a 4. Effectiveness, honestly a 4.3. Because again, the way he gets on defenders is really good. Run defending resistance. Again, this is going to be in 4s as well. He's so good in run defense. 4.1. Speed, not anything special again. 2.3. It's just not great. Whatever. Technique versatility. He can play a lot of different techniques. Especially against run defense. Because again, he is so good at maintaining leverage. And that's again, comes along with a lot of different stuff. This will probably give him a 4. He's just so good in run defense. Like, there's nothing else to say. Relentlessness, again, I will honestly say he does give up sometimes. He's just like, I can't really do anything about it. Like, there's plays where he stops, where I'm like, yeah, he'd probably keep going. He knows when he gets beat, there's really nothing else he can do at some point. So, yeah, his relentlessness is a little lacking. Bull rush, 3.4. Technically his best rush, even though he doesn't really do it a lot. Finesse rush, same exact thing. I mean, he struggles with this a lot, kind of like the relentlessness. He's just not good. Speed rush, just not there too. Like, just not there. Improvisation, he actually does have some decent improvisation. It's kind of like relentlessness, except he doesn't really get right back in the play. So that's kind of the improvisation part of it. He can beat guys. Tackling, 3.5. He makes plays. He can use his arm tackles. He's pretty good here. Like, there's not really an issue with it. His block shedding, honestly, it isn't actually that great. I'll say this, but he gets on his hands. He can move guys, which is huge. 3.6 though, it's not as good as you think it would be, but it's still pretty good. Move toolbox, it's really not a ton of that. It's the technique versatility that's huge. Like run defense, so effective, so fluid with his hand, it's huge. But his move toolbox, again, he doesn't have a ton of different moves, but it's a quality set of him. Now let's get right to his overall. And for Mr. Mozzie Smith, his overall grade comes out to a 3.28, which is a really solid. Again, he isn't above. Honestly, the reason he's like this is because, again, he just doesn't really have much of any passer's value at all, which I get it's not good, but that really does hinder him a lot in terms of this grade. As a run defender, he has the potential to be one of the most gap sound in the whole entire NFL. He's so gap sound. I know that kind of sounds weird, but whatever. He maintains gaps better than any gap buddy in college football. He's the best guy in the draft doing this because he's just so good at maintaining leverage. It's unbelievable. It's his best attribute for sure. Like, it's generational in that aspect. But if he can keep working on that, and he can for sure just become at least somewhat valuable in pass rush, he can be in an elite defensive tackle. I really do think that. But obviously, the best defensive tackles these days are pass rushers. He ain't one of them. That really does hinder him with his grade. 3.28.
Against Clemson. That was all kinds of ugly.
And now we've got the, honestly, other than the number one guy, in terms of just straight up, I'm not going to even talk about the, like, this is more on the play, not on the off the field stuff. For Brian Breesy, he's the most polarizing on the field player in the draft, because in terms of the way you see him, the flashes you see are just, they're flashes, they're legit flashes. He can show he's just a great, great player. But at other times, he's just really inconsistent, which is most of the time. But he's got a high ceiling. His official 40 was 4.86, not the most super athletic. Again, we don't go super in athleticism, whatever. Yeah, weight 305, height was 6'5". Whatever. In 2022, Breesy tackled 13 tackles, 2.5 sacks. Not great. Solid run defender, needs to improve pass rush. He should have stayed back, obviously, pretty much. Has upside, but his best season came as a freshman and has been giving him a higher grade. Have not been giving him high grades for the 2023 NFL draft. Still, this year's draft is weak at defensive tackle, pretty weak, other than the first one guy, actually. So, some teams' sources feel Breesy might sneak in the first round of 2023 NFL, despite his underwhelming 2022 tape and production. But again, he has a ceiling. You got to realize that. Like, he's got the flashes you need to see from a guy, and he's pretty athletic as well. So, yeah, keep that in mind. 15 tackles, though, 5.5 tackles for loss. He is pretty productive. He's very relevant in the run game. And as well, kind of like Miles Sanders, except not, he does have somewhat of a tool package and some versatility in terms of technique. So, keeping that in mind, 3.5 sacks as well, pretty solid player. And we look at Brian Breesy's strength. I gotta admit, he's actually a pretty decent and strong guy. He does hold his own pretty well. Again, he can move guys pretty well as well. And again, in terms of just straight-up strength, in terms of the weight room, 3.3 is fair for him. Beefiness, he's not a super big guy, but I will give him this. He's got some beef, so 3.5. Explosion, he's actually a little bit above average here. He can get off the line pretty fast, and he can definitely get after guys and accelerate in pursuit of defenders. He's actually pretty good at running defense. Kind of like a Greg Gaines in that way, 3.4. Handwork quickness, not something he's super good at, but it's competent, so I will give it a 3.3. His fluidness is definitely something you got to keep in mind. Pretty well-rounded there, 3.3. I wouldn't say it's above average, but it's pretty close. Effectiveness, honestly something he does struggle with, because it points where he doesn't get his hands in the right spot. Well, my bad. He doesn't put his hands in the right spot all the time. That's kind of what it is. Run to defending resistance. He is pretty good here, though. 3.6. He is able to hold his own in run defense. Again, doesn't get flattened. Speed, honestly, actually pretty good. 3.7, I'll honestly give it. He's definitely not a slow guy. Versatility, honestly, it's a little limited considering the fact that we'll get to his rushes. But it's not great. 3 techs really where he lives, but he can play 1 tech sometimes as well, so 3.4 for him. Relentlessness, Jesus. I don't know where to put him here. He has a little bit of an inconsistent motor. I'll give him 2.4. Bull rush, 3.3. His finesse rush is an absolute freaking mess. I don't even know where the heck it is. I'm here 1.9. Because at points, it actually looks okay, but then other points, it's an absolute mess. Speed rush, he actually uses this pretty well. I'll give him a 2. No joke. It's pretty bad. Improvisation, honestly, okay here. I'll give him 3.9. He is pretty good with his improvisation. He can definitely make up stuff in his head. Tackling, okay. I don't know where to put him for this one, because in open space, he makes tackles, but then some arm tackles, just guys throw him off, so that's just not good. But I'll be honest here, I'll give it a 3.5. He's okay there. Block shedding, he can definitely shed blocks. I'll honestly give this a 4.1. It definitely is bad for you. Move toolbox, something he's going to have to develop if he wants to do anything, like be any sort of star in the NFL, but 2.4 for him. Again, for a polarizing prospect, he's a pretty well-rounded dude in terms of just straight-up threes, but let's get right to the overall grade. Amber Bryson Breesy comes out at a 3.11, which I honestly do think is kind of fair, because again, he's a raw player, and he's got a good ceiling, but obviously his pass rush is just not good, and in terms of rushing, he's got nothing. Like, nothing. His roulette, and he doesn't really have much of a motor either, and he's super inconsistent. That's really something he needs to work on. If he can just become more consistent in his technique, it would be huge. If he can really get into that and really can just grind throughout the offseason once he gets onto his team, and get maybe better coaching, especially for his finesse rush, I do think he could be a good, solid pass rusher, because that's what he's got to be in the NFL if he wants to be a star. Because, again, all the best defensive tackles can't stop the run, well, most of them. But all the best ones in many people's eyes and mine are good pass rushers. That's what he's going to have to be if he wants to be really good. 3.11 for him for now. Let's get to the next guy, second overall. Yep, the guy out of Pitt. Here we go.
In receiver second from the top is ineligible.
Here is Hill sacked. First one of the day.
This big man's everybody. He's right here. He's going to come through. And watch what happens when the running back tries to take him on. So he gets past the guard, dumps the running back.
And now let's talk about Kalijah Kansi's grades. Okay, his strength, it's not great because again, he's smaller, but in terms of just straight up pure strength for a small dude, it's okay, it's viable, it's 3.2. Beefiness, he struggles with it, 2.3. There's nothing else to say, he is undersized. Yeah, he is. But will his strength step up? We'll see. Again, he is not as strong as Aaron Donald, as much as people want to make it out to be. Who is this comparison as much as I want to say that? That's the one difference. Kalijah Kansi is not nearly as strong. Can he be? We'll see. Explosion, it's not generational for sure, but I will give it a 4.7. If he can sustain it, it's going to be special, but it's crazy. Quickness, handwork quickness, close to generational, 4.7 again. Fluidness, it's sometimes hit or miss, but overall, it's really fluid. Effectiveness, we haven't gotten the chance to do that because, again, he hasn't gone against offensive linemen that are just straight up as agile as him and are able just to get off the line as fast. For that reason, I'll have to give him like a 3.7, but he's got some effective. He's effective with his hands. Resistance, really don't get the chance to see this a lot, but if he's just one-on-one, the guy, like, they get lashed onto him, we have an idea of what it would be, but again, don't get to see a lot of it. Speed, he really actually isn't super, he actually isn't even really that, like, super-duper-duper fast, but in terms of just straight-up speed, I'll give it a 3.9. Technique, versatility, I mean, you can put him anywhere, like, because in the inside, he's just so just explosive. You can put him literally anywhere. I'll give him a 4.3. Relentlessness, he's pretty relentless, but again, we don't know for sure if he just doesn't win at the line, what he'll actually do. So I'll have to give him, like, a 3.5. Bull rush, not great, honestly. He never has to really use it. What he has to in the NFL, we'll see what he can do. But it's not very effective. His finesse rush, honestly, that's not even his best rush, obviously, but it works. Speed rush, 4.5. I mean, 4, actually. But it is really good. Improvisation, you usually see him doing the same move. Obviously, that chop move. I really like it, but it doesn't always work. So, 3.2. Tackling, honestly, his tackling is actually pretty darn good. I'll give it 3.5. Block shedding, Jesus. 4. It's insane. Move toolbox, he really only has one move, which does limit him. I'll have to give him a 2.5. A lot of 4s, a couple 2s, a couple 1s, again, he's a little undersized, but he's a freaking monster. And Kalijah Kansi's overall grade will be a 3.57, and it's kind of simple what he is. I will take you down. He will take you down. Yeah, he is an absolute explosive pass rusher. That's literally what he is. He could be an edge rusher. I don't even know. Yeah, 3.57. Dude's a freaking beast. So, so good in pass rush. Let's get to Jalen Carter. Yep, he's the number one guy.
Two, but Jalen Carter's got him again.
And I wonder if Kirby Smart will dare take a timeout here.
Did you see that at the end of the play?
Yes,
he lifted him
yes.
up with one hand.
One hand.
My, oh my.
I'll tell you, I think he's the best non-quarterback draftable player. Might even include those guys. But look at him fight through two people.
And then watch this.
Lift him up.
With one hand.
Oh, my goodness.
NFL draft prospect Jalen Carter stemming from his alleged involvement in a fatal crash involving teammate Devin Willock. Video surveillance footage shows a vehicle driven by Carter and the vehicle driven by recruit.
So as much as you want to think that was white noise, yep, Jalen Carter does have off-the-field issues. There's really nothing else to say. It's going to travel him until he can prove it isn't. But yeah, that's the controversy with Jalen Carter. That's why he won't be the number one pick. Because other than that, on the field, he's the best player in the draft. There's no debating that. You could go, he's mean, Bryce Young. No. Bryce Young would get murdered if Jalen Carter tackled him. Jalen Carter, in terms of on the field, forget off the field, he is the best football player. It's him. You could argue, but it is him. Like, if I was going to pick someone to be my number one pick, forget value, everything else, it would be Jalen Carter. His 40 time, yes, it is 5.2, but it was projected as well. But athletically and just straight up strength and just overall, like, disruption, you ain't going to find anyone better. Again, he missed a few games due to a sprained MCL and from a dirty hit versus Missouri. Carter has phenomenal, after returning from blah, 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 dominating over to, okay. He's fast, strong, and athletic, plus plays with excellent leverage. However, team sources say scouts have heard of blah, 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 blah. It's not working, Carter. and they don't believe he loves football. They also are concerned that Carter's last lack of record considered, he is a super talented and as far given talented than the players he plays against. Yeah, another thing. Off the field, Jalen Carter is not what you need him to be. He does not have the tangibles to be one of the best players in the NFL. Talent-wise and on the field, you're not going to find anyone better. But in terms of those intangibles, he doesn't have them. That's it. Could he develop them? Yes. He goes to the right team. But the Cardinals? Nope, not going to happen. But if the Cardinals draft him and Jonathan Gannon can say, you will be what we need him to be, the Seahawks should draft him. Want to know why? Because Pete Carroll knows how to get the best out of his defensive players. He needs to learn how to be disciplined, how to not get luxury. I don't know if he's faced adversity, but Jalen Carter, in my opinion, that's what's going to really be his downfall. If there's going to be a downfall for Jalen Carter, it's the fact that he does not have the intangibles to be an NFL player. He doesn't have the motivation, and he doesn't have that off-the-field crap as well. But on the field, there's no arguing he's the best player in this draft. 32 tackles, 7 tackles for loss, and 3 sacks last year. Man, lack of production. I really don't care. He's that disruptive. He's on film, you just can't ignore him. Like, literally, just straight up can't. But off the field and those intangibles, really, really, really concerning. And as we grade Jalen Carter, his strength, it's a 4. I'll honestly give it a 4.2. He's really strong. He can move guys, even though he's not the biggest. He can move guys. Beefiness, honestly, this is straight up size. He's actually not one of the biggest guys, but he's still pretty big, 3.8. Explosion, it's not collage, it can't see good, but it's 4.1 for a big guy. Quickness, actually not one of his best attributes, but I'll still give it a 3.9. Fluidness for him, it's up there for one of the best in, like, a while. Like, I honestly, you say, oh, he doesn't practice, but he works on this, because I don't know how it's that good. Effectiveness, he doesn't always, this is another, again, you can see this show up sometimes in film where it doesn't always work, but when his hand work, it really gets going, and he can get his hands off defenders, especially on the offensive lineman. 3.6 for this, because again, it's just over if he gets him in the right spot. Resistance, it's like moving a freaking truck. There's nothing else to say. Speed, he's fast. Maybe not 4, but I'll give him a 3.9. He's really fast. Versatility, honestly, he's not the most versatile guy. You probably want to play him in 3 tech more than anything, because again, that pass rush, but I will give him a 3.5. Relentlessness, again, the motor isn't always there, but that's more off-field stuff. He is a beast. I'll give it a 3.3. Because again, the off-field stuff too. Bull rush, can I get this a 5? I don't think I can, but 4.8. It's freaking ridiculous. Finesse rush, honestly, I'll give this a 4.1. It's so underrated. Offensive linemen know they have to protect for that. Because the bull rush, yeah, as bad as that is, like, to play against, it's the finesse rush you gotta worry about. Speed rush, don't really get to see a ton of this, but he's done it a couple times, 3.7. Improvisation, he doesn't have to use it because he just wins every single time, but when he does, it's pretty good, 3.2. Tackling, so one arm tackle tells you everything, it's a 5. He's an arm tackler, I'll just say that. Block shedding, 4.2. I'll give him that. Yeah, it's pretty good. He really doesn't have to use a lot of moves, which I do think will be a little concerning in the NFL, but it still works, 3.4. Here's his overall grade. It's freaking ridiculous. So, the math does not accumulate to this. I'll just put it that way. But, you know, I'll give him a 4.2. Jalen Carter, just to be safe, will be the best, my probably highest graded guy going into the draft. So, I know the math does not come out to this in terms of, like, technically it doesn't, but he, in my opinion, he's a really good player going in the NFL. He doesn't have a ton to develop, but he definitely has stuff to work on, I would say that. Because again, like, he's just such a disruptive player, but again, if that improvisation can improve, and that toolbox gets a little more developed, and the fact that if he becomes more relentless and just more tenacity, and that intensity can be on for the whole game, he's one of the best, he's one of the most impactful players in the whole league. Yeah, but I'd give him a 4.2. I know he can be higher, and again, the math checks out to around a 4, but he's the best player in this draft, so I do have to give him this kind of statistical boost, even though he might not deserve it for sure. Let's just get right to the overall rankings now, guys. 1 through 9, here we go. And our 8th ranked defensive tackle in the 2023 NFL draft will be Keanu Benton. Again, I think he is overall, he's well-rounded, but again, there are stuff he does need to work on, and he's not really great at any particular thing for a run-stopping defensive tackle, of course, out of Wisconsin. He's a good player, though, I'll give him that. Gervon Dexter, again, pretty versatile, but again, just doesn't show much potential and really struggles against some players in terms of pass rush. 2.91 grade for him. Siaka Ika, I'll put it this way, he is Vitavea. He is a defense nose tackle, doesn't provide a ton of value, but in terms of just straight-up size, pretty beefy. 2.95 grade for him. Zach Pickens, I like him because, again, he has a higher ceiling than some of these other guys, and overall, he does have a pretty well-set run defense group, but again, he's pretty good at maintaining leverage as well. Number five for him, 3.08 grade for him. At number four, I got Brian Breezy, 3.11. Overall grade for him. Again, he's got a lot of potential, but again, not particularly really good at anything. Again, he is pretty darn good at run stopping, but again, not like super elite at anything. But yeah, it's a really good prospect. Mazi Smith, 3.28 grade for him. He's a pretty darn good player, of course, out of five with these guys. Again, maintaining leverage, honestly, you could argue he's better than Jalen Carter in some ways, but yeah, Mazi Smith, reason he's here, is because, again, he's just so, can be so good on run defense, but other than that, can't really do much pass rush. That limits him there. Clyde Kancey, 3.57. Again, the real reason he's here is just because he can get at the quarterback and he's super fast. But yeah, that's him. And obviously, Jalen Carter, the best player in the draft. You can argue about whatever the heck you want off the field, intangibles, whatever, but on the field, he's a freaking beast. 4.2 grade. Best player in the draft, probably. We'll see. Interior defensive line rankings top, actually 8, that's a typo, whatever. Keanu Benton, 2.84, of course, is 8th. Gervon Dexter, 2.91, is 7th. DK Ika, of course, out of Baylor, 2.95, is 6th. Zach Pickens is 2.08, is 5th. Brian Breezy is 4th. Mike Smith is 3rd. Kalish Canty is 2nd. Of course, Geo Carter is 1. Hope you guys enjoyed the 2023 NFL Draft Prospect interior defensive line rankings. Yep, that's all I got for you guys. And yeah, see you in the next one. Okay, Kalish Canty. It's pretty simple. You read defensive tackle Pittsburgh, you think of Aaron Donald. Quickest, honestly, probably the quickest defensive tackle ever to come out of the NFL draft. Well, this guy's pretty close. Yeah, he ran a 4.67 40. He's undersized. Yeah, Aaron Donald was too. What is he? The best, honestly, you could argue the best defensive player ever. But for Clash, you can't see. He's an extremely fast interior defender who can fire upfield and penetrate into the pocket, obviously. Off the snap, can't see extremely explosive, possessing phenomenal first step quickness with rare ability to rush the quarterback from the inside. Can't see a special prospect. If he were 20 pounds heavier, he'd be a top 10 pick in the 2023 NFL draft. He is very undersized and does not project as a three down starter capable of holding up in the ground game. Hence, he is a bit of a luxury pick for a team late in the first round or early in the second round that is selling for out for a pure pass rusher. Yeah, that's what he is. He had set, no, not that year, this year. Whatever, 2022. 7.5 sacks, 14.5 tackles for loss. Keep that in mind. Quickness does not mean he can't do anything in the run game. 31 tackles for a loss as well. I mean, 31 total tackles. He is quick. He won ACC Defensive Player of the Year this year, and as well was 5th in the ACC in sacks as well. So yeah, keeping that all in mind, he is a fast, quick beast.
Levis, look at that size! Bulldozes his way inside the 30-yard line.
He's fired up. But he likes it. We talked about it. When this quarterback runs, he gets into the open field to the secondary. Those defensive backs, they got a business decision to make. That time, it was Blaze Aldridge.